So I've talked a lot about what I believe Rockstar should do for the nightclub update in terms of vehicles and properties based off of things they've done in prior games and just what I ultimately think they're going to do. Well, today I'm just going to give you my wish list of things I'd like to see for the Grand Theft Auto Online nightclub DLC. Now, with videos like this, I definitely like to get you guys involved in the comments down below. So I want you to build off of my wish list, maybe add some things extra you'd like to see, maybe take away some things you don't want to see. Just get involved in the comments section down below in this video. Now, I think my friend Austin the Saints fan did this a little bit earlier, and videos like this can only help because there's a chance Rockstar sees them. They might see the support the videos have and say, hey, that's a great idea. Let's include this in the update. And we've seen them do this, them actually look at petitions and see support for vehicles and themes and add it into the game. So every little bit helps. But anyways, let's not waste any more time and let's get it started. So I'm sure a lot of you guys are gonna wonder, you know, what sort of vehicles do I want, et cetera, et cetera. I'm actually gonna start on a little bit of a different note here. I think the nightclub update is going to be a DLC that has the most character-to-character interaction we've ever seen. And what I mean by that is our characters are going to be next to each other, looking at each other, and with each other probably more than ever. Racing DLCs don't provide that. Business updates, for the most part, don't provide that. But because this update is going to be centered around nightclubs where hopefully there's things like dancing mini games, activities where you're together, you're going to be next to your players quite a bit. So the first thing I'd like to see is more haircuts and more opportunities to change our character's appearance. So let's start with haircuts first. The first thing I'd like to see for female characters, get some longer hair or at least some different hairstyles. I feel like the female characters in this game don't get a whole lot of love, especially when it comes to Rockstar providing them with, you know, longer hairstyles, more flowy clothing options, which we'll touch on in a little bit. But starting with that, longer hair options for the girls would be quite nice because all of their haircuts right now are really short, don't really look like female haircuts all that much. So I'd like to see that. As far as the guys go, our haircuts are pretty good. I'd like to see more haircuts. I mean, whatever Rockstar adds would be nice. I'd like to see bigger beards. Like, I don't know why we can't look like a lumberjack or have different style beards to make our characters look a little bit more unique, a little bit more different. That would obviously be a great addition to the game too. Now, talking about other ways to change our appearances, I'm really not too sure what that could be. I know how when Rockstar added the new generation version of the game on PS4 and Xbox One, they added the addition of the contact lenses in the game where we could change the color of our eyes, we could make them look really unique. Maybe Rockstar will do something similar with piercings or face paints, adding more stuff like that. Who knows what they could do? So number one, the ability to change our character's appearance a whole lot more is going to be much needed because we're going to be interacting with our characters a lot. And if they all have the same hairstyle and they all look the same, it's going to look really awkward. Number two, more clothing options. Now, I'm not talking about what Rockstar traditionally do with updates where they've just been adding a bunch of different t-shirts with a bunch of different camo designs and patterns on them. I'm not talking about that. With this nightclub update, I really want to see some unique, really cool modern clothing options for both males and females. So for females, think of things that they would wear out to a nightclub or out to a party. So, you know, fancy dresses or outfits that allow you to go out and have fun. For the guys, more casual hip stuff, maybe an outfit like Luis Lopez would wear. That would be really cool too. Now, in addition to that, I'd like to see Rockstar add more features to the clothing store. So one of those features I'd like to see added is fewer clothing restrictions. So the way we have it right now, Rockstar only allow like certain clothing items to work with certain tops and bottoms. I want them to get rid of that. Get rid of all the clothing restrictions in the game. They don't make sense. They don't allow for freedom and creativity. So get rid of that. Number two, I'd like to see Rockstar allow us to modify outfits a little bit more, whether that be changing the color of various jackets or whether it be moving one patch or something to one side or the other, just allowing us to have more creative freedom with outfits to make designs the way we want. I understand Rockstar's hesitation when it comes to this. They're worried about clipping. They're worried about people making weird glitched outfits. But I think for the most part, people are just going to have fun having more creative freedom, designing what they want and how they want their characters to look like. And as I've mentioned throughout this video, I feel like this is going to be tremendously important because our characters are going to be interacting with each other, they're going to be dancing with each other, etc. Whereas with other DLCs, we might not be as closely connected. So that's what I like to see as far as clothing and character upgrades go. I feel like those are two big important categories right there. Let's move on to the nightclubs themselves. I'd like to see Rockstar open up a good number of the nightclubs. I really don't want it to be where there's like four locations in game, because that would be really awkward having just, you know, 30% of the people all owning one nightclub in the game. I'd like for it to be more spread out, and there's plenty of in-game options that Rockstar have already built and established that they could allow us to own. I'm not really going to go into the specifics in this video because I've done so in other videos in the past, but having a lot of nightclub options to purchase and own would be nice. Now, once we own and purchase those nightclubs, I'd like to have customization on the inside. I'd like to be able to change the color of the dance floor, add exclusive mini games as well. That's another thing I want to talk about, whether it's a dancing mini game or whether it's something like pool that you just simply can't do in any other place. I want to make the nightclubs worthwhile, because if they're not worthwhile or have anything exclusive to them, they're really going to lose their value. And I don't want that to be the case, because this is a theme that I've been looking for a really long time now. So having customizable exclusive things in the nightclub would be a great addition. Additionally, I'd like to see Rockstar utilize the mainstream nightclubs they already have in the game. So Tequila La, Bahama Mamas, I actually don't think we're going to be able to own those. Instead, how I think it's going to work is they're just going to be open to the public. And if that's the case, I would love it. Allow us to go inside Bahama Mamas, dance, hang out with our friends. I think that would be a great addition to the game. So now that we've got properties out of the way, let's talk about vehicles. So I think vehicles are going to be a big part of this update, but it's also a little bit hard to figure out what Rockstar is going to do, because we don't really know the theme of the other update that's supposed to come along with the nightclubs DLC. According to recent leaks, it's going to be a two-in-one update. Nightclubs is going to be one theme, another theme is going to be the other. So I'm not sure what that's going to be. However, because I think this update is going to take a lot of references from The Ballad of Gay Tony, which is the Grand Theft Auto 4 expansion, I'm really hoping for a lot of GTA 4 vehicles. The PMP 600, the NRG 900, the original Turismo from Grand Theft Auto 4, the original Corvette from GTA 4 2. Lots of throwback vehicles would be quite nice. And Rockstar have been doing that. They've been adding lots of vehicles from previous GTA games, like the Hermes from Vice City. That was fantastic what they added in, the Doomsday Heist. So lots of additions like that would be great. Other than that, I'd like to see Rockstar mix it up a little bit with the vehicles. You know, I want to see a good mix of supercars, sports cars, sports classics, muscles, coupes, sedans, stuff like that. I don't want them to get too focused on one category here. And I'd also like to see a nice addition as well, like a good amount of vehicles, which I'm assuming they will. I feel like in the last update, the Southern San Andreas Super Sports Series 1, we didn't get a ton. And that's kind of showing now as we're getting into the drip feed and there's not really a whole lot coming out. Moving on, let's talk about weapons. So I really hope Rockstar add new weapons into the game and not just the Mark II weapons. I know Mark II weapons are super easy for Rockstar to do, but there's a lot of great ones from The Ballad of Gay Tony that they could add. They could add the golden micro Uzi that belonged to Yusuf Amir. They could add the explosive shotgun. They could add a couple of other pistols that haven't been featured in the game that were in The Ballad of Gay Tony. So there's plenty of options right there. And that doesn't even mention all the other weapons from the GTA series that Rockstar could offer. Even fun and wacky ones, like the katana or the flamethrower. Something fun like that that would kind of go along with the super cool nightclub vibe that we're going to be getting from this update. So fun weapons, weapons from The Ballad of Gay Tony would be great additions to the game as well. After that, I'd like to see some general quality of life improvements. So what I mean by that are things that just make the game a little bit overall better and unique. Now, one thing I have in mind is being able to either purchase an unlimited number of properties or at least one more. recreational property. Because you know Rockstar is going to add a ton of DLC cars in this update, where are we going to store them? It's pretty unlikely there's going to be vehicle storage in the nightclub, so I'd love to be able to add, you know, another floor to my office garage or buy another 10-car garage. You know, that seems like a logical thing that Rockstar could pretty much easily add, just adding more space so that we can buy more vehicles so that we can spend more money. I mean, you would think that's a thing they would do immediately, but we haven't really seen that in the last couple of updates. So I'm not really too sure what's holding Rockstar back. That's one quality of life thing I'd like to see. And the other quality of life thing I'd like to see, and I'm not sure how the nightclub business is going to work, but I'd love it if they were to clean up the SecuroServe app, if they actually made that useful, if they were to clean up the CEO, VIP, MC system a little bit. Right now, it's a little bit funky. It like jumps from various phone screen to phone screen and interaction menu to interaction menu. I wish there was a better way to manage that. And I'm sure there's a ton of other quality of life features that I'm missing in this video and I'm not even talking about. But more changes like that would definitely be greatly appreciated. So I think I really covered the big four right there: properties, cars, weapons, clothing, and then things we can do to our character and quality of life changes. Again, if you guys feel like I missed anything, let me know in the comments down below. But that is my personal wish list for what I think we should see in the Grand Theft Auto Online nightclub DLC. Like I said, I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. Add some things you feel like I didn't have. Maybe take away some things you feel like might not work. Let me know your thoughts, opinions, more in the comments down below. If you did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And also, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new or you like daily GTA 5 videos like this. With all the way, guys, like I said, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.